Kevin from South Africa. My first hunting trip in New Zealand. I stay here now. I've moved over. Done a lot of hunting in South Africa, so I'm keen to see what's out there for me here. I hope it all goes well.
Awesome.
Yeah, hi, Gary from Hawke's Bay. I'm a friend of Kevin's, work with him. I've come down to have a wander around as a spectator and to see what it's all like. I've done a lot of hunting, so it'll be interesting. I've hunted down this area quite a bit further down the coast, so I'll be interested to have a look this side.
So. Awesome, guys. Sounds like it should be a pretty good trip. We've got good weather and everything, so everything's looking quite promising. Hopefully we can get Kevin his first New Zealand bird deer. I'm quietly confident we'll be able to, so we've got a night. We've got two hunts to do it, so we've got this afternoon and tomorrow morning. I'm quietly confident we should be able to get it done this afternoon, but don't get our chickens before they hatch.
Before they chop, before we eat them. Yeah.
All right, should we get into it then, eh?
Yep, let's go.
All right.
Make a living from walking in the woods. You can bet I'd be sitting pretty good, high on a hill, looking at a field downwind. If I can make a nickel off of turning in bass, never worry about the price of gas. I'd be wheeling and dealing and sitting there reeling them in. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting, fishing and loving every day. I get a little farm pond buzz, sound of gravel when I'm backing up, pulling a string on a 9.9 two-stroke Murphy. I love it when my baby wants to roll with me, throws her boots on, climbs in a tree, tucking her hair in my hat and she's ready to go. And we get to hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Y'all are up there breathing in that old dirty air. I'll be down here knee deep in the muck of leaf. Hunting and fishing, loving every day. I wanna see them tall pines sway. Y'all close them eyes, let's go there in our mind. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. That's the prayer this country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Black coffee in the morning, dark whiskey in the evening. I get red dirt rich and Flint River pay. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Loving every day.
now. I've just put the fire, put the jug on, and sent the boys up the hill. They're just going to have a look out over the other side there, see if they can spot the animals. We'll have a bit of a brew, a couple of chocolate biscuits, and then we'll head out the door about 3 o'clock, 3:30, and hopefully we can find Kiva's first New Zealand red deer. Nice fat one as well for him to eat. Should be pretty good though, quite promising by looking at the sign on the way up the track, so I'm pretty sure we should be able to find one for him, no problems at all. Probably shouldn't have said that, but we'll see how we go. Alright, boys are just putting their boots on, about to head out the door. Weather's looking pretty good. So we're going to head down to one of our shooting stands. This paddock hunting's bloody fantastic. So we'll go down there and we'll sit in there for a couple of hours and hopefully something pops out. See what happens. And gullies and just squirreling around and back down, and those deer got their scent and bug it off. It was a gift anyway, so it would have been too easy. Get him behind. See the other one still standing there?
No, just take one for now.
Just one for now, okay. Man, nice shot. The old 7.5 Creedmoor does a fantastic job. Just poleaxed it. Behind Blake. Nice stuff, mate. It's your first New Zealand red deer. Good shit. Yeah, it was a beautiful shot, 210 metres. Awesome, mate. That 6.5 Creedmoor, I'm quite impressed with that calibre.
Yeah, I love it.
Everything I've, all the clients I've taken out that have had that calibre have all done nice, good, clean kills like that. And we could take that one over there. Well, she's just disappearing into the scrub now.
Let's not be greedy.
Let's not be greedy, exactly. Oh, awesome, mate. Nice shooting. It's a good eating animal too. It's good size.
Good eating, nicely on the shoulder.
Beautiful. Here's a look at that. We'll call it cold, eh?
Cold, yeah.
Awesome, mate. Oh, we'll go and recover her. Got a bit of an obstacle on the track. Gonna have to get me a little silky saw out and clear that, and we'll do that, hopefully. Boys just gone around the face to try and find the deer, and Blake has decided to go with him. I'll just clear this and hopefully I can get the bike around there. Well, there you go, Kev. What do you reckon of your first New Zealand red hunt?
Yeah, it was really exciting. We had to sit a while and then eventually they started coming out and we had to do a little bit of a stalk on this one and pulled up a good shot on it. Pulled out the river. Now we're ready to go home and do a bit of socialising. A
couple of beers and
I think so.
Possibly have a crack at another one in the morning.
Definitely have another crack. It was exciting.
Okay, we'll see how we go in the morning. We might be able to find another one for you if we're lucky.
Oh, that would be great.
Sweet, well we'll sort this one out and chuck her on the bike and get back to the hut. Luckily we lit the fire before we left, so it's pretty chilly out here.
Yeah, it should be nice inside.
Yeah, mean. No, awesome, mate, good stuff.
Yeah, thank you.
So, 130 grain Sarco cartridges. This is what you use tonight to knock your deer over with the 6.5 Creedmoor.
Yeah.
And Tikka T3X with the Zeiss scope on it.
Yeah.
And that Sarco ammo obviously does the damage.
Yeah, I've had two shots, two animals, and this was my furthest at 210 meters, spot on where I aimed.
And it was straight through, just in behind the shoulder
straight
too.
Through, yeah.
And yeah. It just poleaxed it. She it just rolled. Dropped. Yeah.
It rolled nasty.
So here you go, ladies and gentlemen. If you got a Tico or a Sarco, go and buy the old Sarco ammo, because it definitely shoots good. That's been basically made for the Tikas and Sarcos. So go and buy some. Good ammo, and it kills really good. That's 130 grain you're using there.
130 grain, yeah.
Yep. And do you want to tell us the story, mate? You just
not now.
Kevin was just telling us a story about back in South Africa, and he's out hunting, and a bloody rhino was only a metre or so away from him, and he doesn't want to talk on camera now, but we'll get him. Get a few more ranfurlies in him, and some of this bloody
Cedric Soul Brown
into him, and he might loosen up a bit, and we'll be able to get a good story out of him.
In the evening.
But there you go. I definitely rate that Sarco ammo, and I definitely rate the 6.5 Creedmoor as well.
Oh, it's a very nice gun.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So we'll have a few beers, and we'll cook tea, and then we'll go to bed eventually.
Maybe.
And then we'll get up and. Quite keen to take another one in the morning. The hind that we got tonight, she's a little bit skinny. She's not in the best nick. She was a dry hind as well, so we'll try and find a nice wee fat yearling for you, so you'll get the full taste of a nice eating New Zealand red deer rather than a skinny old dry hind.
Yeah,
that awesome. What's that feed like there, Gary?
Superb feed, thank you very much. Well deserved after a big day.
That's good, that's what I wanted to hear.
Yep. Very rewarding day. That's great, thank you.
Awesome. So those of you that have been hunting with me before, you'll probably see the old nachos on the table again. It's a bit of a Hooney Rata hunting trait. Venison mince. It's bloody fantastic.
Just poured myself a reward drink.
Did you have ice?
A little bit, not much.
I'm not
hearing. Oh, okay, that's fine, mate. You keep your eyes. Good sleep?
Yes, lovely. Nice fire. Cozy.
Good.
Lay down. Eyes were shut. Ready for another day.
That was quite cool hearing some of the stories from South Africa hunting there. That's bloody good.
Yeah, it got better as the evening went on.
Ah, awesome. Yeah. Starting to get a bit of light in the sky, so boys are just getting ready, and we'll head down the hill and see if we can find another deer. Up. Shoot it. Oh no, it's down. Awesome there, Kev.
Yeah, it's a good one down.
The old 6.5 Creedmoor does it again.
Yeah.
That was just in behind the shoulder, was it?
Yeah. Not as far as the shot last night.
That'd be 100 metres.
Yeah.
And
we picked up a nice bigger one.
Blake
ran a bit, got us a bit excited, and then fell over.
Yeah, I thought we were going to have to give him another one there, but yeah. I could see the blood coming out of just behind his shoulder, so he was buggered. He just didn't know it. Mean, so you got two nice deer. Their hind last night was a little bit skinny, so we thought we'd try and find one that's reasonably fat this morning. So that one there looked like he was in a pretty good nick. Yeah. Didn't know we're here. One, well, they actually did get busted there, the dog.
Did look at us, but it put his head down again.
Yeah. Well, Blakey bloody started doing his squeaking
what
again.
Do
get him behind. So, been talking to Gary last night, and he's done the old blueprint dog training. And he was telling me about letting Blake go from here is the wrong thing to do. That's why he's gets keen and starts whining and all that sort of stuff. So, and maybe does the circle around the rifle. So we're not going to say go get him or anything. We're just going to keep him beside. So I'm going to try my different training technique. I have no idea how to train a dog. I've just winged it all my life.
Yeah, nice Gary, because he's been told he's a bad
the biggest problem trainer. My dog is a shit owner.
Yeah, the shit owner.
At least he's honest.
Stay there for me.
Some do a pain. Yeah, pretty with you.
Ooh, that definitely was a bit far back in my shoulder. Yeah, it was fucked. I mean, it's
behind Blake.
Yep.
Keep forward and you'll hit the bit back.
Yeah, don't end it. I'm going right in here. Oh, too close. Oh, this is drunk. Oh, that was a headshot. Well done.
Yeah, you're
liking
my gun too much.
I do, I like it. Well, there you go, Kev. There's your second New Zealand red deer. A little bit different than hunting on public land, obviously a bit easier and a lot more deer around. But it gives you a bit of a taste of it anyway, what's to come.
Yeah, we had a nice early morning start, a cup of coffee. Out, it was a bit misty and rainy, but got through it and it cleared up a bit and we found a couple of nice females standing on the hill, and we picked a nice one, put a good shot on it, ran a few meters, fell over nicely.
Yeah, so this one is in a lot better condition than the first one. This one's a nice young.
This one's going to be on the table, the other one's going to go into processed sausage and stuff like that, but this one's definitely going to be enjoyed on the table.
And we've got a couple of Arapara sheep there that were coming over from the old safari park next door, so. There was a nice hogget by the look of it, a ewe and a lamb and a ram. So you've got some tasty mutton to mix in with your
It's a bit difficult to shoot you when the pH grabs your gun and just takes over.
I couldn't help myself.
But it was fun.
I've never shot a Arapara ram, and I said to the boys, oh, I've never shot a ram, and there's one there, and the farmer wouldn't want these breeding with the stock, which they would do. So we thought we'd get rid of them, and they're just eating grass. That's another thing that's just eating grass here, so we'll get rid of them. And I've got a set of horns to chuck up in the shed, and the boys have got plenty of
meat to take home.
Meat to take home, yeah, exactly. So we'll sort this animal out, and I'll scoot back up the hill and grab the quad, and the boys will go over there and recover my ram that's halfway stuck up that steep face. And hopefully they've already done that by the time I get down. I might stall a bit.
Get lost.
Awesome, mate.
Oh, lovely stuff, thank you.
No worries.
Yeah. Off to retrieve our sheep. One up here, and should be one up. One up by that tree. There's one right here in front of us. Okay. Yeah, it's a good little one here. There's one right here, which we'll drag out onto this little flat. Yeah. Perfect little sheep. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, no, that's a good headshot at 250 meters. 250
was it? Well, Creedmoor, innit?
Yeah.
It shoots alright. I mean, it's, you're taking someone else's gun and you can just pull a shot off like that.
Yeah. Yeah, he'll be good eating. Right, so we should have one just up here above us. And we'll go up there, we'll climb
somewhere
that
around the corner there.
Up in that tree there, so. Which one do you want?
Oh, you just go up.
Hey, I'll just cut it onto this ridge up, that ridge where they were.
Yeah, he ran that way. He never came out again.
He didn't get out past that tree, might be just above that tree.
Yeah.
I'll wander up and have a look.
Right,
yep. Ram should be right here, right in front of me. It's actually a good ram. Nah, nothing wrong with that. Hello, buddy. You're a pretty little fella, aren't you? Hey? Yeah. One more type sheep thing you're going to do. Oh, I don't think we'll break any horns. Come around here. I'll move it only so can roll down with the other ones. There you are, guys. Ready? There you go. Yeah, perfect.
These are the boys there, just sorting out one of the arapiras. Shot back up to the top and grab the bike. I'll just grab the gear from here and then scoot down to the bottom and give them a hand.
Alright, got our sheep. Now we're walking back up the creek. Kevin hasn't put his over his shoulder because he gave it a wash.
Arapara ram, a lamb, and a ewe. So the boys have got some, and a bit of venison as well, so boys have done all right.
Very successful morning hunt.
Very good. Yeah.
They didn't have them back to the bloody, back to the quad though by the time I got here.
No, we could have, but we actually set them away.
No, we just waited for you to come. Yeah.
They made me carry the ram back with my bung ankle, so. No, it's all good. We're just getting rid of these because we don't want them on the farm, basically breeding with the stock here. So we just got rid of them. Set of horns there. I don't even know if they're good ones or not. They don't look very. They look all right, but I don't think they're fantastic or anything.
No, I think they're representative.
Yeah, exactly. That'll look good with all the other bits of bone I've got hanging around the place. It'll be quite cool. Sweet. So we'll load these up onto the bike, and then we'll head back to the hut and. Cook us a feed, eh?
Oh, that sounds good.
Mean. Exciting times. Just seen a fallow buck of a lifetime. Kelly, the farmer's wife, actually seen him a little while ago and told me about him. And I was like, oh, I've sort of been looking out for him because I've never shot a big fallow buck myself. And we're just cleaning up after breakfast and Kev wanders out and has a look around for his binos and comes back in and says, oh, there's a nice big stag down there. And I said, oh, yeah, he's just seen a red stag, you know, an 8-pointer or something, and walked out there and he's this beautiful, big, majestic fallow buck. He looks like an absolute cracker. He'd be well in the 200s. So I haven't shot a good fallow buck yet and hopefully we can get a sneak on this one. The wind's perfect, everything's ideal. So we're going to have to sneak over to there. He's only here.
I think I
I got him.
Yeah.
Just in time. I had to fucking get him on the run, or he's going to disappear. So yeah, I just couldn't pick him up.
I'm behind Blake.
Well, well, well. Woohoo! Just got myself the best buck of to date. My personal best, that is. That's a beautiful big buck. So just from the hut too. The hut's only there. And a big fucking buck right there. Bloody rack of a buck. Happy as. Had to shoot him on the run, otherwise he was just going to disappear. So you had to put one into his spot.
Got a habit of stealing the client's weapons.
I've actually got more trophies than my client. I've got a ram and a fellow buck on this trip. I've done really well. awesome, mate. Thanks for doing the camera work for us. We'll get over there and have a good look at him, eh?
Yes, I think.
Mean.
Right. So this is my personal best fellow buck. It's a fucking ripper. I'd say it'll be around the 220, 230 mark, I would imagine. Just as a bit of a rough guess, he's chipped off a couple of times. He's broken that one and he's chipped off his brow tines there. But definitely lots of character. Definitely a big old boy. Pedicles are flat on his head, pretty much. Teeth are worn right down. Bloody top job, and the hut's only just there. Story goes that Kevin just walked out to have a look for some deer with the binos and comes wandering back in and says there's a nice big stag down here. And we'll just have a wander, no desperate hurry. And this fella's just smoking away down here, and we snuck over and he actually busted us. I was lined up on him, ready to go, just waiting for Kevin to get the camera on, but he couldn't figure out how to focus it. And the next minute he ran, so I had to do the running shot, gave him the Texas heart shot, and that stopped him in his tracks, and it was enough time for another couple of them just to put him out of his misery. So bloody awesome meat hunt for me, taking Kevin out from South Africa to get his couple of first red deer, and managed to knock over a ram for myself and a beautiful fellow buck. So, and like I said before, the owner had seen this buck here, and I've sort of been looking for him. I was allowed to shoot him if we'd seen him, because he's a cracker. So yeah, personal best. I think this one will be going up on the wall with the rest of them. Awesome.
Well done.
Excellent. Well done. Not a bad problem to have there, Clayton.
Yeah, it's fun actually, mate.
Yeah, looks pretty good, mate.
A guide and a meat hunt and get yourself one.
yeah, I'm not sure who the guides and who the hunters are here, but we're all good to go, so
that's good. Awesome, guys. Thanks for spotting it for me. No problem. Always pays to have a few extra set of eyes around the place, eh? No, that's awesome. I'm wrapped.
All right, let's get back to the bike.
Yeah, right.
Oh well, guys, looks like you guys have had a pretty fantastic meat hunt.
Well, it turned out to be better than we thought it would be, and a couple of nice animals. Quite happy,
yeah. No, that's awesome, mate. So we've got two deer. One's a little bit skinny old hind. She was dry as well. So we went out this morning and managed to get that nice wee young hind, and she'll be absolutely beautiful eating. And then these arapaos come out, so we thought we'd get rid of them. They're just grass eaters basically, and they could possibly breed with the sheep here as well, so we don't really want to get that mixture going on the farm. And then we're having breakfast, and lo and behold, this big bugger walks out, and the farmer's wife actually told me about him, and she said his head made his body look out of proportion, which it did a little bit.
Yeah.
And he was only just down from the hut. Well stuff, shot a big fellow buck before. And he was sitting there in the sun, dark. It was too hard not to take, basically. So we'll take him, and he's old, and his teeth are worn, so we took him a good time too, I think. But overall, what do you guys reckon of your Ohini Rider hunting experience there, mate?
Very good. We were promised some nice animals. We got some nice animals. The hunting was good. Accommodation was perfect. Just what I expected. Clayton was a perfect guide, except for when he grabs our gun and shoots the animals. But we had fun. It was, we really enjoyed ourselves.
Oh, awesome, mate. Thank you. It was a pleasure taking you out. Actually, a couple of good buggers. Even Gary.
The dog doesn't like you, mate. The dog's off it, but everything else is good.
So, my battery's flashing, so we might have to cut this short a bit, guys. But you know the drill. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, especially subscribe.